You said it almost as outrageous as what they're trying to do with this.
Jeez.
This is, it's actually really kind of horrifying. It was some things we want to just count on. Don't mess with the Oreo.
Well.
The classic American cookie.
Well, see, Frito-Lay started this. Remember before the Super Bowl, like probably about 5-6 years ago, create your own potato chip, and they got it down to three, and one would be selected the winner.
All right, that's one thing. That's a potato chip. That's like you spray a couple of flavorings on it. That's different.
Okay, Oreo's doing the same thing, though.
They completely different baked-in, horrible concoction. You're changing the DNA of the cookie.
I agree wholeheartedly. Well, they had Fruity Pebbles was the mystery Oreo. Don't you remember? I won't buy them unless they're normal.
Here's the three new limited edition flavors of Oreos. Ready? Cherry Cola, Kettle Corn, and Pina Colada.
Now, these went through, like, taste tests to make sure that people actually liked them.
They were first submitted by the public to submit suggestions. The brand selected were the finalists, and then the company used judging criteria and all that other stuff. Here's my question to you. What maniac suggested Kettle Corn Oreos?
I haven't a clue. Probably the same people at the Texas State Fair that came up with fried Twinkies and fried Oreos.
That I even get. You take an already existing food and you deep fry it. This is horrifying.
Well, what's going to happen is these all show up in the stores today, and whichever one is voted the fan favorite. Okay, say you were the one who submitted the Cherry Cola Oreo. You win $500,000.
Is it $500,000?
It's $500,000.
Oh, wait a second. Hold on. I'm changing my tune on this. I'm in.
So,
you know what I want? Jack Daniel's Oreos.
Oh, there you go. See, now I'll be in for that one. Yes.